I'm going to go over a water current problem, which is also a rate times distance problem. But the difference here is that the speed of something, in this case a dolphin, gets helped if it's going in an ocean that has a current, that it's going along with a current, and actually he goes slower if he's going against the current. So let's look at this problem. A dolphin swimming against an ocean current traveled 60 miles in 2 hours. It then turned around to swim with the current and was able to get back to its starting place in 1.5 hours. Find the speed of the dolphin in still water and the rate of the current. Now, if you look at the first sentence, you might notice that the dolphin went 60 miles in 2 hours. So against the current, the dolphin was going 30 miles per hour because you just do distance divided by rate. But that isn't really the speed of the dolphin. The dolphin's actually faster if he was going without any current traveling against him. So that's the trick here. All right, so let's see. We're trying to find the speed of the dolphin in still water and the rate of the current. So we need to define both of those things. So this is makes it naturally a two-variable problem. So let's let D represent the rate of the dolphin in still water and C be the rate of the current. So just keep in mind that if the dolphin is going with the current, the speed of dolphin with the current, it means he gets a little boost. It's the dolphin speed plus the little extra amount of the current. And the speed of the dolphin against the current slows down. You would take away C. Okay, we're going to use that. And I'm going to put this in a chart to keep track of this important information. So we'll go back to all of the words in a minute. We're going to make up a chart. So we're going to use our formula that rate times time equals distance, and we're talking about how fast the dolphin is going against the current and with the current. So the dolphin's rate against the current. Well, if we look up here, let's see. What did I write? The speed of the dolphin with the current is d plus c, and against it's d minus c. So against it, we have d minus c. Okay? Because it slows them down going against the current. And with the current, it's d plus c. Now we need to go back to the original problem and see what it told us about the time. Here we go. It said it tra against the current, it traveled 60 miles in 2 hours. So let's go down here. Against the current, its distance was 60 miles in 2 hours. Okay? So we're able to fill in the rate, d minus c, the time, 2 hours in 60 mile, 2 hours he went 60 miles. All right, and what else does it say? He turned around, was able to get back to its starting place, which means what? He went the same amount of distance. So when he returned, he also went 60 miles. But the time is 1.5. Now, you can write that as 1.5 or 3 halves. It's up to you. But this is our information in a chart. Now, this will give rise to two equations. The first equation will be it against the current, the rate times the time equals distance. And the next one will be going with the current, the rate times time equals the distance. So put this on pause and see if you could write the two equations. All right, so to write the equations, we need to take the rate times the time. I'm going to write instead as the time times the rate, so the 2 is in front of the parentheses. D minus C equals 60. So we get that from against the current, the information. With the current information, we've got 1.5 times D plus C, or d plus c times 1.5. Again, I think it's easier to write the 1.5. out in front. And we've got 60. Okay, now, you could go ahead and do your distributive property here, and then we could use the addition method or any other method you'd like. But it's actually easier if you get rid of the number in front of the parentheses. So if I divide both sides by 2, notice these 2's cancel, and I just have d minus c equals 30. And we could do the same thing over here. Divide both sides by 1.5 so that the 1.5's cancel. And then I have to do 60 divided by 1.5. So you can use your calculator. You could use long division. But you should get d plus c equals 40. Now, I'm not a big fan of calculators myself, so I'm just going to show you how I would do this problem. If I have 1.5 times d plus c equals 60, I like to think of that 1.5 as 3 halves. And then multiplied by the reciprocal, which is 2 thirds. And that way, I end up with just the d plus c on this side because the fractions cancel. And then I've got 3 goes into 60 twice, and I have d plus c equals 40. So that's how I do it. I like using fractions and not having to get out my calculator. But we'll go back to here. In any case, you should get d minus c equals 30 for one of your equations, and d plus c equals 40 for the other equation if you use this technique instead of doing the distributive property. And notice how nicely that works out if I put those one under the, if I put the d plus c equals 40 underneath this other equation. The addition method is pretty simple here because the c's cancel. And I have 2d equals 70. And now if we divide both sides by 2, we'll get d equals 35. Now remember, d stood for the rate of the dolphin in still water. So this 35 is going to be talking about 35 miles per hour, which is pretty fast, but we're talking about a dolphin. We also need to get the rate of the current. So we could go back to either of these two equations to get the rate of the current, either d minus c equals 30 or d plus c equals 40. You could probably do that in your head if you put d plus c equals 40 and if d is 35. Hopefully you'll see that c has got to be 5, right? 35 plus 5 is 40. And of course you would get the same thing if you did 35 minus 5. Is going to be 30. So the rate of the current is 5, the rate of the dolphin is 35. Now I've got to go make sure that this makes sense given the original problem. So we got that the rate of the dolphin in still water should be 35 miles per hour and the rate of the current would be 5 miles an hour. And let's see if that makes sense. It says the dolphin swimming against an ocean current traveled 60 miles in 2 hours. So we're going to do the rate times time distance and see if that really makes true. So against the current, if the dolphin is 35, you're going to have to subtract 5 so that the rate is really going to be 30, that it's really swimming, times the 2 hours, and that means it should have gone 60 miles, and that worked. And then we're going to go with the current. All right, going with the current, right, it turned around, and if the dolphin's rate was 35, we're going to have to add 5 this time because he gets a little boost. So the dolphin going through the water is really going at 40 miles per hour, and he's going for 1.5 hours, right? 1.5 hours or 3 halves. So we do 40 times 1.5, and we get 60 as well. And remember, you could have written that as 40 times 3 halves, and you would also get 60. So it depends how you want to do your arithmetic. So this is the correct answer. The rate of the dolphin in still water is 35 miles per hour, and the rate of the current is 5 miles per hour. One quick note. The original problems we had, 2 times d minus c equals 60, and 1.5 times d plus c equals 60, I told you it was easy to divide both sides by 2 for the first equation and by 1.5 on the other. If not, this is what it would take to get d equals 35. You would do the distributive property on both, get rid of the decimal on the right-hand side, write the two equations right here, multiply the top equation by 15, the bottom equation by 2, so that the c's would cancel out. You get a lot of big numbers, but you will get the same answer.